Good morning, children. I am Sarveshwari, working as PGT Economics in APMS Dharmavaram. So today we are going to revise the lesson, The People. So if we listen the word, people means immediately development. That word will come into our mind. Especially there is a relation between the development and people. So population growth is the main problem that we face today. That is exactly related to development, because in our country, that means in India, population is growing day by day. So in the total world, we occupy the second place in the population. See the map. This is the map, world map, according to the population. This is the map showing the area of country on the basis of population. See how is it different from other world maps? This is the world map related to the area of countries on the basis of population. See, China is the first biggest country, next our India. This is totally different from the real world map. So population growth is the main problem that we face today. So all of you know that if suppose in one family there is only 5 members, then all will get sufficient food or any resources what they want. Suppose if the family grows, that is 10 or 20 members, then all will share less amount of food and other resources. So in the same way, in our country, population is growing day by day, but the resources are limited. We cannot share the resources all equally. So 92% of the working people in India are in the unorganized sector. So already we have discussed this point in the last class. So 92% of the working people in India are in the unorganized sector. They have to struggle for work and have no other security. So population. So how do we compare that we have more population when compared to other countries? So we have to know the exact number by census. Census of India provides us with information regarding the population of our country. So the people who do this survey go house to house and find out the number of people in every house and in every village, town, city. This census provides us with a lot of information. Lot of information means that in every house, how many people are living and how old they are, their occupation, next their education, what is their religion. So each and every information the people gather who will go to survey. Okay, so for every 10 years, the Registrar General and Census Commission of India organizes the collection and recording of this information. In India, the first census was taken in 1872. But the first complete census, however, was taken in 1881. So census have been held for every 10 years once. So last census done in 2011. So on that time, our country's population is 121 crores. But actually for 2021 again they had to do survey, but due to corona, census had not held in 2021. But the population grown, I think nearly 139 crores. I don't know exact figure, but it is now 139 crores. So how this increase, see, all of you observe. So according to the 2011 census, nearly 62 crores are men and 58 crores are women. Observe this table. I think all of you done in your class this survey. So the people who will go to do the survey in every village, they will collect the information by making this table. That means for in every household, for every family, how many male are there, how many female, and what is their age and the school education. Suppose if they are above 15 plus, what is their occupation. Like this, for every family they conduct one survey. So I think all of you done in your classroom this survey near your house. Next, here after the survey they will make a rough figure that in that village how many male and how many female and total population. Like that they will calculate total India's population. In that also so many categories are there. So for children 6 to 14 years, how many male child, how many female child. Next, total children. Next, how many are at school and how many children are dropouts and how many children they never enrolled in school. So they will make survey like this also. And another table here given. So 15 to 59 years, how many of them are self-employed, their percentage, and how many are homemakers, and how many are in job, unemployed, students. Like this they will do survey. So what does the census show? So census shows the age structure. So age structure of a population refers to the number of males and females in different age groups in a country. So total population is divided into three categories. So first one is children, that means below 15 years. So you come under children only. Next group, working age. So 15 to 59, that means your parents. Next group, aged above 59. So your grandfather or grandmother. Okay, so first we will discuss about the children below 15 years. So you are the children below 15 years. You comes under first category, children. So children are generally taken care of by the family. So whatever they want, food or clothing, education, medical care, whatever the children want, family, that means head of the family, father or mother, they will take care of the children by providing all their requirements. Because children do not earn money to support themselves. Because they are kids, they have to go to school and study. That's why children do not earn money themselves. They will take help from their parents. So parents will take care of the children by providing everything, whatever they want, education, food, clothing, any requirement or medical facilities, whatever they want, the people, whatever they want, family will take care of the children. Next, working age. working age means your parents come under in this category. See, usually this group forms the working population in a society. They are also biologically reproductive. Most people in this age group desire decent income and security of work. So many people working in our country above 15 years and below 59 years. Most of the children and aged people depend on this earning group. Your parents are earning money for your livelihood, isn't it? So next, aged, that means 59, above 59 years. Those who have been in a salaried employment or in organized sector, they may get a retirement pension. I think many of you in your families, your grandparents getting their pension, not old age pension. So if they are in organized sector, means they will get the retirement pension up to their death. I think in your family so many grandparents are getting pension from the government. But most of the grandparents are in unorganized sector. Majority are working in agricultural laborers, domestic workers, construction workers and others. Usually continue their work as long as they are physically fit. Because in unorganized sector, they will not get any income for their livelihood. If they work, they will get income. That's why above 59 years also, so many grandparents are working to earn some money for their livelihood as long as they are physically fit to work. These groups, suppose if they are not physically fit to do job, means these groups depend on their families for support in old age. So children and aged above 59 years all will depend on working age group. So children also depend on their parents and old age parents also depend on their children. So if we compare that first group and second, third group will depend on second group, that is working age group. So generally after 59 years, grandparents, that means old people, will get so many diseases. So their medical expenses are higher than that any other group. So they have to do work if they are in unorganized sector. Suppose if they are in an organized sector, they will get retirement pension by sitting in the house itself. So they are happy because they will get some amount and they can spend on any requirement, whether medical or any other. But in an unorganized sector, they have to depend on the working age group. Nowadays, old age. So here one graph given, see, population pyramid of India. So here age in years. So see here male and female percentage given in this graph. Nowadays government providing so many schemes for different groups. All of you know that for children, government is providing midday meal schemes, Anganwadi programs, and nowadays so many schemes are providing to people who are below 15 and above 59 also. So now government school children are getting midday meal scheme, and you are getting books, bags, everything. You are getting. Next, for old age people also, so many facilities are giving government. So for every old people, I think 2500 government is giving for every month as a pension. but with that pension they are unable to live, they are unable to satisfy their requirements. That's why after 59 years also so many people are working in our country to satisfy their needs.
X ratio is the number of females per 1000 males in the population. That means number of females survive for every 1000 males in the population. This information is very important indicator to measure the equality between the men and the women in the society. So all of you observed that in our country there is a discrimination between men and women. So here one graph given, see, in 1951 number of females 946 survived for every 1000 males. In 1961 it decreased, 941 only. 1971 again number of females only 930, again decreased. In 1981 934, in 1991 929, in 2001 933, and 2011 943. So from 2011 onwards number of females surviving increased 943 for every 1000 males. So we noticed that number of females in India has been lower than that of men. Female male ratio, sex ratio, is a cause of concern since it indicates a hidden form of discrimination. Generally, according to medical research, females can survive more than males below 5 years. So, but in society, there is a social discrimination. So many women face unequal opportunities for education and development. So basic needs also, that is nutrition, child care and health, also they are discriminated against. They get less of these things than males. I think this is happening in the every family, isn't right? So I am not telling about your family, but you will see that in so many families boys are treated more than boys are giving more importance than girls. Parents send boys to higher education, but for girls they will stop for 10th or inter or degree only. But nowadays it is a little bit better because female ratio is getting increased nowadays. So I observed that mostly in villages females, that means girl babies, are treated less when compared to boys, not only in education but also in other requirements, that is nutrition. So general ga ekku villages lo em chestarante abbaylnemo baaga vedi vedi annam pettadam, tarvata manchi cloths ivvadam abbaylki, tarvata vallaki हायर स्टडीज वरकू पंपिंची मंची जॉब्स वच्चे वरकू वाळ्ळ मीद खर्चु चेस्तारु. कानी अम्मायिलकि मात्रं चदुवु मीद एंदुकु खर्चु पेट्टडं, वाळ्ळकि पेळ्ळिळ्ळु चेयालने उद्देशंतो अम्मायिलकि चदुवु तक्कुवगाने कोद्दिगा चदिविंचि ఆపేస్తారు. తర్వాత ఫుడ్ ఇచ్చే విషయంలో కూడా అమ్మాయిలకైతే కొద్దిగా ఏదో చందనం ఉంటే నువ్వు తినేసేయమ్మా అని చెప్పడము, వాళ్ళని ఎక్కువ పనులు కూడా ఇంట్లో అమ్మాయిలకే అప్పచెప్తారు. ఇది జరుగుతూ ఉందా మీ ఇంట్లో అంతా? ఉండదులేండి. ఇప్పుడు ఎందుకంటే కాలం మారింది, ఇప్పుడు పేరెంట్స్ కూడా బాగా వెల్ ఎడ్యుకేటెడ్ కాబట్టి దే ఆర్ ట్రీటింగ్ ఈక్వల్ గర్ల్స్ అండ్ బాయ్స్. బట్ before 2011 there is a lot of discrimination between boys and girls. Medical research also shows that girl children survive better than boys. If there was no discrimination, then the number of girls should be higher or much as of boys. But from the census, we got the information that females are less when compared to male. In India, 103 female babies are born against 100 male babies. However, more female babies die than male babies because actually, according to medical research, female babies survive more. But what really happening means more female babies die than male babies because there is a discrimination in their care and nutrition. Otherwise, the physical chance of survival is better for girls. In most families, if the parents are educated, then they will treat the female baby and male babies equal. But in where there is no education in family, then there is a discrimination between boys and girls, men and women. When we observe this table, here sex ratio is more in Kerala. See, 1040 in our India. But USA is 1050. In our country, there is a more literacy in Kerala. That's why in that state, sex ratio is more. That is, sex ratio is positive. For every 1000 males, their number of females survived is 1040. So now, within India, certain parts of Kerala have a positive sex ratio. Well, some other regions, observe this table. So, Haryana, Punjab, AP having less sex ratio when compared to Kerala. One of the worst manifestation of this pro-male bias is relatively higher mortality rates of girls compared with boys. So, do you know that mortality rate? Mortality rate means puttina ventane ekku ammayilu chanipothu unnaru. Kani abbayilu ekku mandi bagunnaru. Kani actual ga medical research prakaram ammayilu physical ga survive avvadaniki ekku chance undi. Ila enduku jarugutandi ante ammayilu health vishayamlo neglect chestunnaru. Ade male children aithe ekku caring. That's why male children are surviving more than females. ఇంకా ఏం చేస్తున్నారంటే మామూలుగా అమ్మ కడుపులో ఉండగానే కొద్దిమంది అమ్మాయి అని తెలియగానే అబార్షన్ చేయించేసుకుంటున్నారు. అట్లా చాలా జరుగుతున్నదన్నమాట ఎక్కువగా మన ఇండియాలోనే. ఎందుకంటే అమ్మాయి అంటే తక్కువగానే చూసేవాళ్ళు. అమ్మాయిలు పుడితే వాళ్ళ కేరింగ్ కానీ వాళ్ళ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ ఎక్కువ వస్తాయి, వాళ్ళకి కట్నం ఇవ్వాలి, ఇదంతా ఉంటుందనేసి అమ్మాయి అనగానే ఫస్ట్ అబార్షన్ చేయించేసుకుంటూ ఉంటున్నారు. ఇప్పుడు కూడా ఇంకా అక్కడక్కడ జరుగుతూ ఉంది. వాళ్ళ దృష్టిలో ఎట్లా అంటే అబ్బాయి అంటే వాళ్ళ ఇంటి పేరు నిలబెట్టేవాడని, అబ్బాయి అయితే పేరెంట్స్ని బాగా చూసుకుంటాడు, సో మన వారసుడు ఉండాలి, మన ఇంటి పేరు చెప్పేవాడు ఉండాలి అని అబ్బాయిలనైతే కంటారు. కానీ అమ్మాయి అనేటనే కడుపులో అయినా కూడా చంపేస్తున్నారు, లేదా బయట వచ్చిన తర్వాత అయినా సరే వాళ్ళకి కేరింగ్ లేకపోవడం వల్ల ఎక్కువ అమ్మాయిలు చనిపోతున్నారు. అందుకనే సెక్స్ రేషియో అనేది చాలా తక్కువగా ఉంది. హర్యానాలో కానీ మనం చూస్తే 870, పంజాబ్లో 880 ఫర్ 1000 మేల్స్. ఇన్ ఏపీ అయితే బెటర్, మనం 970 ఉన్నాం. బట్ కేరళ ఈజ్ వెరీ గుడ్, 1040. So due to the preference for male children, parents may decide to abort the female child before death, not after death. Some parents decide to abort the female child before death because many families consider female children as a burden. They have to expense more on girls. That's why they think that female children as a burden. So studies have shown that male priority in health continues for adults, rising the mortality rates of even adult women above those of adult men. Not only in the case of children, so పెద్ద వాళ్ళ విషయంలో కూడా చాలా డిస్క్రిమినేషన్ అనేది ఉంది. అమ్మాయి అయితే జాబ్ చేయకూడదు అనేసి, ఎక్కువ చదువులు చదివించకూడదు, ఎక్కువ చదువులు చదివిస్తే ఇంకా అంతకు తగ్గు ఎక్కువ అబ్బాయిని ఇచ్చి చేయాలి, కట్నం ఇవ్వాలి అనే ఉద్దేశంతో అమ్మాయిల్ని తక్కువగానే చదివిస్తున్నారు. తర్వాత ఇంకా ఎక్కడైనా జాబ్ చేయడానికి కూడా ఉమెన్ని పంపించారు. ఎప్పుడైతే ఎవరి ఫ్యామిలీలో అయితే పేరెంట్ అంటే అమ్మ ఎడ్యుకేట్ అయి ఉంటుందో ఆ ఫ్యామిలీలో మాత్రమే అమ్మాయిని అబ్బాయిని ఈక్వల్గా ట్రీట్ చేస్తున్నారు. ఉమెన్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఈజ్ వెరీ పవర్ఫుల్ ఇన్ రెడ్యూసింగ్ ద డిస్క్రిమినేషన్ ఇన్ ద ఫ్యామిలీ. ఇప్పుడు అది ఒక సామెత చెప్తారు కదా, ఇంట్లో అమ్మ చదువుకుంటే ఇల్లంతా చదువుకున్నట్టే అనమాట. సో అమ్మ చదువుకొని ఉండాలి అంటే ఏమి, ఇప్పటి నుంచే మనం ఇంకా పిల్లలుగా ఉన్నాం కాబట్టి పిల్లలు బాగా చదువుకొని, ముఖ్యంగా గర్ల్స్, నాట్ ఐఎమ్ సేయింగ్ ఓన్లీ గర్ల్స్ బట్ అలాంగ్ విత్ బాయ్స్, అంటే వాళ్ళతో సమానంగా అమ్మాయిలు కూడా చదువుకొని పెద్ద పెద్ద చదువులు చదివి అబ్బాయిలతో సమానంగా జాబ్స్ సంపాదించాలి. అప్పుడే ఆ ఫ్యామిలీ హ్యాపీ ఫ్యామిలీ అన్నమాట. ఎప్పుడైతే వాళ్ళ ఇంట్లో ఉమెన్ ఎడ్యుకేట్ అయి ఉంటుందో ఫ్యామిలీ అంతా రిచ్ లైఫ్ బతకచ్చు. అంటే డబ్బు పరంగా అయినా సరే, వేరే అదర్ ఏదైనా సరే, ఇంట్లో అమ్మ ఎడ్యుకేట్ అయి ఉంటే ఆ ఫ్యామిలీ హ్యాపీ ఫ్యామిలీ. నెక్స్ట్, లిటరసీ రేట్స్. సో అకార్డింగ్ టు ద సెన్సస్ ఆఫ్ 2011, ఏ పర్సన్ ఏజ్డ్ 7 ఇయర్స్ అండ్ అబౌవ్ హూ కెన్ రీడ్ అండ్ రైట్ విత్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ఇన్ ఎనీ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఇస్ ట్రీటెడ్ యాజ్ లిటరేట్. సో అకార్డింగ్ టు ద సెన్సస్, ఏ పర్సన్, దిస్ ఈజ్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ వన్ మార్క్ ఇన్ ద పబ్లిక్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూ, ఏ పర్సన్ ఏజ్డ్ 7 ఇయర్స్ అండ్ అబౌవ్ హూ కెన్ రీడ్ అండ్ రైట్ ఇన్ ఎనీ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఇస్ ట్రీటెడ్ యాజ్ లిటరేట్స్. సో లిటరసీ ఈజ్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ ప్రోగ్రెస్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ కంట్రీ. So if there is no literacy, then our country will never become developed. If the literacy increases, then our country goes in the development way. Okay, so literacy is very important for every country to develop. In 1947, only 12% of the population was literate. Just see, in the time of independence, very little percent, only 12% population was literate. In 2001, it was increased to 64.84%. So by 2011, it grew to 74.04%. So there is a rapid increase in the literacy by 2011. But literacy increased, but there is a disparity in literacy rates between the men and the women. See here, observe this. For men only 82.14%, but for women only 65.46%. See, again there is a discrimination here. Literacy increased from 1947 to 2011. There is a rapid change, literacy increased. Okay, good. But even though literacy increased, there is a discrimination between the men and the women. See, only women literacy is only 65.46%, but male literacy is 82.14%. So still we have to increase our literacy rates in the point of women. Next, working population. So it was pointed out earlier that in this lesson only I have told that who are in the age group 15 to 59 are working people. Now itself we have discussed that there are people are categorized into three groups: children below 15, working age group 15 to 59, and aged above 59 years. So they might work the whole year or only a part of the year. This depends on the availability of work. So I told that 92% of the population are working in an organized sector. So they don't work for the total year because there is no availability of work for them every day. Whenever they find work, they will work for those days only. So if they don't work, they are not given salary. Okay, we have discussed earlier. Now see here, table. Working population, workers percentage of work. Cultivators are 25%. Agricultural laborers are 30%. Workers in household industries, so 4% and 59%. Other workers are 41%. So Census of India groups them into four categories. That is working population. Again divided into four categories. Cultivators means farmers. All of you know that. Farmers who farm or supervise the land that they own or take and rent. So agricultural laborers means they are not having any land. They work on another's farm for wage, isn't it? So agricultural laborers and coolilu. Cultivators means farmers. They own land or they take on rent. Okay. Next, workers in household industries would be those who are manufacturing or repairing some product at home, such as dehusking of paddy, BD workers, potters, weavers, repair of footwear, manufacture of toys, matches, etc. These categories come under household industries. So they are doing small jobs, that is repairing or BD workers, making pots, weavers, they all come in this category. Other workers would be those who are employed in factories, trading, casual labor and all other occupations. How is an agricultural laborer different from a cultivator? Agricultural laborer means coolilu. They work for daily wages. They don't have their own land. They will do work on another's farm. So cultivators means they have their own land. They farm their own land or supervise the land. Okay. So these are the categories in the working age group. Next, population density. Population density means it is calculated as the number of persons per unit area. It is also very important for one mark. It is also important for one mark. Okay. Population density definition they will ask. It is calculated as the number of persons per unit area. India is one of the most densely populated countries of the world. So the population density of India in the year 2011 was 382 per square kilometer. So idi ela lekkistarante oka area lo ante oka square తీసుకొని ఒక ఏరియాని 1 కిలోమీటర్ తో అక్కడ ఎంత మంది నివసిస్తున్నారు దాన్ని పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ అంటాం. సో పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ ఎంత ఉంది మన ఇండియాలో ఎవరేజ్ గా అంటే 2011 లో 382 పర్సన్స్ పర్ స్క్వేర్ కిలోమీటర్. కానీ ఇండియా అంతా కూడా ఒకటేగా ఉండదు, డెన్సిటీస్ అనేది చేంజ్ అవుతూ ఉంటుంది ప్లేస్ ని బట్టి. సో ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇన్ బీహార్ పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ ఇస్ 1106 పర్సన్స్ పర్ స్క్వేర్ కిలోమీటర్. ఇన్ అరుణాచల్ ప్రదేశ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ వెరీ లెస్, సీ ఓన్లీ 17 పర్సన్స్ పర్ స్క్వేర్ కిలోమీటర్. ఎందుకు ఈ డిఫరెన్స్ ఉంది, ఎందుకు ఈ డిఫరెన్స్ ఉంది అంటే ఆ ప్లేస్ ని బట్టి. ఎక్కడైతే బాగా రిసోర్సెస్ అన్నీ ఉండి మంచిగా ఫార్మింగ్ కి ఉంటుందో అక్కడ పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ హైగా ఉంటుంది. ఎక్కడైతే హిల్ ఏరియాస్ ఉంటుందో ఫారెస్ట్ ఏరియాస్ ఉంటుందో అక్కడ పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ తక్కువగా ఉంటుందన్నమాట. అస్సాం అండ్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది పెనిన్సులర్ స్టేట్స్ హావ్ మోడరేట్ పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీస్. హిలీ డిసెక్టెడ్ అండ్ రాకీ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ది టెరియన్ మోడరేట్ టు లో రెయిన్ఫాల్ షాలో అండ్ లెస్ ఫర్టైల్ సాయిల్స్ హావ్ పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ ఇన్ దట్ ఏరియా. సో నార్థర్న్ ప్లెయిన్స్ అండ్ కేరళ ఇన్ ద సౌత్ హ్యావ్ హై పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్లాట్ ప్లెయిన్స్ అండ్ ఫర్టైల్ సాయిల్స్ అండ్ అబండెంట్ సాయిల్. వేర్ దేర్ ఈస్ అ అబండెంట్ రెయిన్ఫాల్ విత్ ఫర్టైల్ సాయిల్స్ అండ్ వేర్ దర్ ఇస్ అ ప్లెయిన్ ఏరియా దేర్ ద పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ ఈజ్ హై. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిమెంబర్ దిస్ పాయింట్. వేర్ ది పాపులేషన్ వేర్ దెర్ ఈస్ అబండెంట్ రెయిన్ఫాల్ ఫర్టైల్ సాయిల్స్ అండ్ ఫ్లాట్ ప్లెయిన్స్ దేర్ ద పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ ఈజ్ హై. వేర్ దెర్ ఈస్ అ లెస్ ఫర్టైల్ సాయిల్ అండ్ లో రెయిన్ఫాల్ అండ్ ద టెరియన్ అండ్ ద రాకీ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ది టెరియన్ హిలీ రీజియన్ దేర్ ది పాపులేషన్ డెన్సిటీ ఈజ్ వెరీ లెస్. సీ హియర్ one map given, you have observed that here distribution of population density in India. Some colors are given here. So where there is high rainfall, there the population density is high. Where there is less rainfall and forest area or hilly region, there the population density is less. Here Andhra Pradesh map given. Here the population density for every district also given here. So which is the highest where is the highest population density in our Andhra Pradesh? Observe all of you. Krishna, isn't it? In Krishna there is a the population density is high because there is a river in that district and that's why the people living in that area are more. So here different population densities are given for every district. We have to read all these for the public point of view. Okay, thank you everyone.